After much wait and much anticipation, the Cosmic Desktop alongside PopOS 24.04 LTS went into their beta releases back during September. Now, I can't speak for the entirety of PopOS, but when it comes to the Cosmic Desktop, I do think the wait was worth it. There are still things I would like to see, things like changing the handling of client-side and server-side decorations, shifting the priority more towards the server-side, window focus, not causing windows to jump up and down when you set window focus delay to 0 seconds, and of course things like HDR support and other things which are becoming more and more expected on a modern desktop. But the core workflow is there. The alpha was good towards the end, but early alpha, if you looked at it in the wrong way, you could cause it to crash. When it comes to the crashing bugs now, for the most part, it's more obscure things, it's weird combinations of features, it's weird combinations of hardware. For most people, it's probably gonna be in a pretty good state. There are still less serious bugs that do need to be dealt with, like the fact that in the widget menu for the bar, if you grab one of those widgets and then just drag it outside the window, it's just no longer in the list. Now, it's still in the bar because it's still technically in the list, it's just not visually in the list. So you reload the settings and everything's back to normal. That's not a critical bug, but it is something that probably should be ironed out. But when it comes to the release model, weirdly they're doing kind of the opposite of what you might expect. So normally you'd expect fast-moving, very iterative alpha releases, and then slower, more intentional beta releases. That's not what they're doing. So let's go to the tagged releases, and you might remember that back during the alpha, mostly it was one release every month. Sometimes there was a 0.1 release, but most of the time it was one a month, sometimes it was 2 months, but generally following that pattern. With the beta though, they're doing these faster iterative releases, more like a rolling release model. You probably heard about beta 1 coming out with a lot of people talking about it, me doing the stream and a lot of things going on, but you never heard the announcement for beta 2, beta 3, beta 4, and there's probably going to be a beta 5, beta 6, beta 7 with no announcement being made. Like, Carl's not making a post, there's not a blog post about it on the System76 website, because these are more like alpha releases than the actual alpha releases. That doesn't mean they're unstable, but they're shipping things considerably faster. Now, it's not like the development pace of Cosmic has drastically changed. It's just the rate of tagging has been massively increased. And I get it, but it's kind of weird for a beta, and it would have made more sense if this was the model they were just using the entire time. It allows people that are using the tagged releases to go and, test out the new features considerably faster than before. If you're using a tagged release during the alpha, you could reasonably be 3 weeks behind on features, 3 weeks behind on bug fixes, and anything you report very possibly could have already been resolved. So the only way to reasonably test Cosmic during that time was to be using the Git build. Do note though that even though there are these frequently tagged versions of Cosmic, they're not rebuilding the PopOS ISO for every single one of these. They were doing that back during the alpha, back when there was this slower paced release version. For this though, if you want to go and test out the new versions, you're better off doing it on something like an Arch Linux, like a Fedora, something where they actually are bringing in these new packages and making it very easy to test. And I don't know how many more there's going to be, but there will come a time very, very soon where this is going to go from beta to stable, to release version, to whatever they actually want to call it, because we now know when Cosmic Stable is going to be released. The air quotes are there for a good reason. Carl, on many occasions, has provided dates, and then those dates were not hit. But this is a date for PopOS as well, so hopefully this one is hit. PopOS 24.04 LTS and Cosmic Epoch 1 will be released December 11th, 2025. That's not an RC version. That is not an early release version. That is the stable version. And Epoch in this context just means a collection of software. It's not some like weird fancy release term. It's just what they are calling their release versions. I have my fingers crossed that this date will actually be met. I don't think there's going to be some like drastic change between the beta that exists now and the release version, but I really want people who were worried about trying alpha software, worried about trying beta software, to really be able to give Cosmic a proper try, because this first version is going to be good. Like, it's already in a good state, but that's from my testing, that's from others' early testing. When you give that to the average person who hasn't tried Cosmic, who are going to try things that I haven't thought of, that a lot of other people haven't thought of, with weird hardware combinations, you're going to find some bugs. First releases for everything always have a lot of issues, always have a lot of things that people realize are missing that should have been there from the start. So I think you should try it. But I think your expectations should be kept in check. And very importantly for future releases, future PopOS releases starting with PopOS 2604 LTS will now align with the Ubuntu release timing, approximately 2 weeks after the Ubuntu release date. So if I understand that correctly, 24.04 LTS is coming out in December, and then about 4-ish months later, then they're releasing PopOS 2604, and then they're going to be on the Ubuntu release schedule. So this is probably going to be one of the most short-lived LTS releases ever created. I don't know of anything that has a 4-month LTS window. Maybe, like, maybe some bread. Yeah. Maybe a head of lettuce. Now, they don't have many options here. They can do what they're doing here, which is release something a month from now, release something again to get back onto the Ubuntu cycle, and then everything be good from then. They can say, we're going to release nothing until 2604 LTS, and then be on the cycle, but I'm sure they really want to get a stable release out way before then. The other option is just say, you know what? We don't actually care about these release cycle, these release windows, and just do our own thing. But I am sure that Carl and everybody else on social media is sick of answering the question, why are you guys on 2204 LTS, but it's 2025? Why are you on 2404 LTS, but it's 2026? Just getting back on cycle will finally fix that problem, if nothing else. And this is really big for PopOS because until now, the project was kind of in limbo. It was still being maintained, but because of that whole, oh, it's based on 2204 LTS, even though it is doing the whole PopOS semi-rolling thing, it creates a situation where it seems like things are not being maintained to somebody who might consider using PopOS. And ever since that last version, a lot of distros have come along to kind of fill the void it left. Things like CashiOS, all of these various other gaming distros, Bazite to some extent, and PopOS is used for more than just gaming, but gaming is kind of the thing that was like putting it on the map. It's Ubuntu, but it doesn't have stupid kernels and stupid drivers for gaming. I'm curious what sort of interest is going to be around PopOS after all of this wait between releases. Is there going to be this resurgence of interest? Are people going to try it out once again? Are people even going to care whatsoever? I'm very interested to see what happens here. And for those who are currently using PopOS, yes, there is going to be an upgrade path between the two of them. Keep in mind, though, it will be going from GNOME to Cosmic. I don't know if it's going to clean up all of the GNOME files, so it's very possible there's going to be a lot of, like, junk left over. If you're really worried about that and you really want a clean upgrade, I would frankly just do a fresh install. Now, most of this was just about PopOS. And Cosmic is not going to be following the PopOS release model, and that's probably for the best, because one new desktop every 2 years is about four times as slow as what GNOME and KDE do, and it doesn't need to be like that. You have a team of developers, you have people that are working on it, things are going to be ready long before then. So when it comes to those releases, someone asked the question, will Cosmic Epoch 2 be released with PopOS 2604, Epoch 3, 2804, and so on, or will Epoch be incremented between one LTS release and another? Carl says, Cosmic Epochs are a collection of features we plan to release during the next development cycle. They're separate from the Pop release schedule. Cosmic is a rolling release desktop environment with releases each week. Some US holiday weeks will be skipped. Cosmic will be updated in distros based on the packaging policy and release schedule. For Pop, it's continuously updated as features pass QA. So, with this specific mention of features here, this sounds very different from the GNOME and KDE model that are built around the Ubuntu calendar. So Ubuntu has releases in April-ish and October-ish, and GNOME and KDE, not as much traditionally, but they're moving into this model, release roughly around the same time to make it easy for these distro maintainers, along with Fedora as well, to have the latest version on that new release. With it being rolling, this is a very different model, because GNOME and KDE do have these minor releases in between, but they're not feature updates. They're bug fixes and security fixes and things like that. Here it sounds like there won't be a distinction, and as things are ready and as things are tested, they'll just be released. This is probably going to work really well for distros like Arch Linux, but if there was an Ubuntu Cosmic, I don't see that functioning in their model. It probably works better in the Fedora model. Fedora tends to be more willing to ship things at a more continual pace, but I'd be curious to see if this sticks around long term, or if this is just a temporary thing as, you know, basic things are being added. What I mean is, when all the features are there that people expect to be implemented, there's much less of a reason to have this fast-paced release model. It adds a lot of extra strain onto the development team. There's extra testing that needs to be done on a very frequent basis. So this is why a lot of the other desktop environments, alongside obviously the Ubuntu model, don't release at a pace like this. Again, I don't know what's going to happen, you know, 2-3 releases from now, but that would be my expectation, that things do eventually slow down. But I could also see it not changing because it does align with what PopOS itself is doing. So, like Cinnamon and Mint, where they're kind of like tied together, and yes, there's Cinnamon on other distros, but that's like the main place. That's the same way it goes with Cosmic and PopOS now. Yes, there is Fedora Cosmic. Yes, there are packages on Arch Linux and various other places, but they're very much tied together. And PopOS also has this semi-rolling model where certain parts of the distro roll updates in rather than just being this, like, old Ubuntu base that's, like, you know, 2 years, 3 years out of date depending on when you're running it. So having the desktop be part of that as well, and that is specified that at least for now, that is what is going to be done. So it's possible that it just stays like that and nothing ever actually changes. It would be nice to see a major desktop environment not have the same release model that everyone has. I understand why they have it. It just makes it easier for everyone if they all operate on the same schedule. But at the same time, Cosmic doesn't really need to care about that because System 76 sort of has that whole release stack. They have hardware they sell, they have a distro they make, and now they have a desktop they make. So even if other places find it inconvenient to package, they always have that base to rely on. And I, for one, am very curious to see where this goes. When the stable release comes out, I will definitely be doing a Cosmic stream, and we will be finding bugs with it. Now, hopefully, a lot of the bugs are ironed out by the stable release, but I know for a fact that there are bugs there that haven't been looked at for about 6 months, and I know for a fact they're still in the code base because I reported them. So we will see if some of those ones get fixed, because if they're not, I'll definitely be having some fun with that. Anyway, let me know. Have you tried out Cosmic so far? Did you try during the alpha? Have you tried during the beta? Are you waiting for stable release? Do you even care about Cosmic? I'd love to know. So if you like the video, go like the video, go subscribe as well. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out my Patreon, subscribe, Stelly Barapay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and space is fake.